Hi everyone. In the previous class, we have seen one of the property called overflow property and the concepts like CSS list and CSS tables. Okay, fine. Now in today's class, we will see two more properties. One is a display property, very, very important. And another one is a position property. Okay, fine. These two are very, very important. Yeah, fine. So this display property is used for controlling the layout of elements. Controlling the layout of every HTML element. And coming to position property, it is used for to arrange the HTML elements in the document. That is the difference between this display property and position property. Yeah, meaning that, for example, there is a element called H1 element. Where I need to arrange this H1 element, in which position I need to arrange this H1 element, that is going to define with the help of a position property. And display property means which is going to define the layout of this element. So that layout means that layout can be, already while explaining HTML, I said already every HTML element can be either an inline element, or it can be block level element. That is what I said, right? So there itself I have explained clearly. So inline element means these are the elements which is going to start from the previous location itself. Meaning that these are not going to start. Doesn't start at new line every time. Whereas coming to block elements, these are going to start at new line. And these elements are going to occupy the entire width of the document. What about these inline elements? These inline elements are going to occupy only the required amount of space. So that is the difference between the inline elements and block level element. Yeah, fine. So if you observe here, H1 is a kind of block level element. Right? So if you would like to convert this into an inline element, then I can go for the property called display property. If you observe some of the block level elements, division tag is one kind of block level element, H1 tag is one kind of block level element, paragraph, form, link, list tags, list of items tags, these are all various kind of block level element, meaning that these are always going to occupy the entire width of the document. Yeah, fine. Coming to inline elements, like anchor tag is there, which is going to occupy the required amount of space. Span tag is there, which is going to occupy the required amount of space. Image tag is also there, which is going to occupy the required amount of space. Okay, fine. I mean, by default, every HTML element is either an inline element or a block element. Yeah, fine. So let me show some simple example so that you will get clear idea. I can go with adding the data after the text and font effects, which is available in the container class, right? Yeah. So here I will add. Yeah. Or else I will take, okay, fine. No problem. I will take the new one, para class equal to, this something some name I have taken. yeah
I have taken it as branches. And one more data, B class equal to this one, branches, CSC. ECE mechanical civil. Guys, observe here, if I press F5, what happened? Try to observe. Branches is in one line and CSE, ECE, mechanical civil is in one line. Meaning that what happened, guys, here paragraph tag is a kind of block level element, meaning that this element is going to occupy the entire width of the space, the entire width of the document. So I hope if you would like to show that, well, I will use style tag border 1 pixel solid red color, let me take. Yeah, observe, guys, you will get this border over the entire page or entire document. So entire available document. See, observe. So that is why we are saying that it is a block level element. So whereas coming to this bold tag, which is a kind of inline element. If you observe, it is going to take the space only the required amount, meaning that it is going to require the space for only 3 characters. That amount only it is occupied. It doesn't occupy the entire document. Yeah, fine. So and observe here. Yeah, so after completion of this block element, I have written the inline elements, right? So this inline element starts from which location? This inline element starts from the immediate location. But whereas coming to if I go for writing one more paragraph, class equal to this only, yeah, end of branches, I'm taking style. Yeah, so guys, if I refresh, what happened? For which I have added, yes, sorry, I have added for another one. Yes. If you observe now, as this end of branch is a kind of block element, it is going to start in the new line. Yeah. Whereas coming to, for example, I would like to add an image. Image source equal to, I think, n.jpg. Yeah. So if I wish, I would like to define height and width. Height is 250 pixel. Width is 300 pixels. Observe. So image is also kind of inline element or not? Yes. So it always starts from the previous location. It is going to occupy the required amount of space. Here also, if I would like to define a style border, you can observe. Yeah. For this one, you will get the border. Go with 5 pixels. Only the required amount of space it is going to take. Yeah, fine. So this is the difference between the inline elements and block level elements. Yeah, fine. What will happen is sometimes it is necessary for us to change the layout of the document. Why it is necessary to change the layout of the document? For example, my CSC, ECE, mechanical, civil all need to come to the next layer. I mean, CSC after next line, CEC, next line mechanical, next line civil, like that I need to get. At the time, what we need to do is, we need to change this default property. So, if you would like to change the default property of every HTML element, the required HTML elements, I will use a property called display property. So, the use of display property is used to change the default property of an element. Will go for display property. display property. It is going to support four values somewhere. One is you know already a block, which is meant for block level element. Another one is inline, which is to define for inline elements. Another value is inline block. Another one is none num. See, we have more some more values are there. Flex, grid, flex inline. These are all various kind of things are there. But right now, you don't require that much in-depth knowledge. Yeah. So once you practice, you'll get understood that also. Okay, fine. Yeah. So when you write display equal to block, what is the purpose means? It is used for to convert an inline element into block level element so that these block level properties will be get for that particular element. Inline, which is meant for to convert a block level element to inline element, and we'll get the properties of inline elements. Okay, first let me complete this block and inline so that you'll get much more clarity. Now what my requirement is, I would like to change this to the right. CS is inline, EC is inline, mechanical inline, civil is inline, right? I would like to convert them into block level elements. Block level element, yes. Yeah. What I did is I will take that class display one class. Yes. Dot display one. Yeah. I will simply write yes, what is the default property of that? Inline. Now I am going to modify it to block. Sorry, 1 minute. Yes. Absolutely. I have refreshed it. What happened? Automatically that inline property converted into block. See, it is going to take the complete width of the document. Yeah. I didn't apply the style for all the things. No, fine. If I observe here, I didn't write anything. I made it comments. What happened again? It has converted to inline. So the default property is inline. If you wish to change it to block level element, then I can go for changing it to the block level element. Yes, I have modified. Yeah. Okay. Fine. Okay. What I will do is see, observe guys, here there is a list. So in the last class I have shown this example, right? This is a kind of unordered list. For this unordered list, I have added a list of items, and by using list style image property, I have added some images inside the border. So list style position using inside the border, I have added an image. Yeah. Now what I did is so right now also I have explained list item is a kind of block level element. That is why it is going to take the entire width of the document. Now my requirement is I want to convert this block level elements into inline elements, meaning that so that all can occupy the required amount of space only. Yeah. For that, what I will do is I will go for this list. Yeah, navigation list, right? So here list items are there. So I think in the list items I have added. Yeah. So list items I have taken, right? So by default, these are all going to display in the form of block level. Now what I will do is I would like to convert into inline, meaning that I need to take only required amount of space and I need to start from the previous position. Yeah. Observe guys, if I refresh, what will happen? Yeah. Let's convert. Am I getting or not? Yes. So that is the use of display. I have converted this block level elements into inline element. Now, can I convert this in the form of the same structure? Yes. Observe border, which is red color, right? Yeah. I can go for border radius. I'll go with 5 pixel. Yeah, it has got something. So I would like to remove the underline. So for that I can go for text decoration is none. Hmm. 1 minute. Where I need to write, not a list, list. Any data is there? Yeah, fine. For it's not for L items. In that shell elements are there, right? Li. Yeah. I need to remove the text decoration. Yeah, fine. So anything I would like to modify? Yeah, that's it. So if you used to have modifications, you can do anything. So meaning that I have created the buttons with help of as well links as well as another list, the same thing. Yeah. Now, for example, I would like to convert this image property. Yeah. So I have added an image, right? So this is already a block level inline element. Yeah. Observe. I have added one more image of same style. One more image. Observe what happened. It is going to directly occupy in the immediate next level, immediately to the next image. Okay, fine. If I add once again, immediate to the next. Yes, right? Yeah, fine. Now I don't want like that. I want to get in the form of block level element, meaning that required amount of space it need to occupy. For that, what I can do is I can go for class equal to. I will take some DI display. Yeah. For example, I would like to have only the last element, or I would like to have only the first element. Then I will take the only apply the property for only first element. Dot DI is equal to block. So guys, only first element will be converted to the display. What we call a block element, and remaining will be as it is in the same line. Yeah. I don't want like this. Yeah, I will make it is common. Yeah. Fine. So I think I have covered both inline and block. Yeah. Now what my requirement is? So these are the various kind of anchor tags, right? Which you already know. So now I would like to convert them into a block element. As anchor tags are going to act as an inline, now I would like to convert them into block level. Now I think yeah, fine. Navigation links anchor tag. You observe the code also, you can observe navigation links, all the anchor tags are act as a inline elements. I would like to convert them into block level elements. Then what I can do simply, I can go for display equal to block. Right, so observe what happened. They have converted into the block element, and they have taken the complete width of the page available. Am I right or not? Yes. Now, yes, it should be a block element. And it should not have to occupy the complete width of the page. I need to restrict that. Then I can go for a property called max width property. Meaning that, if you would like to restrict a block element to how much space it need to occupy, instead of occupying the entire block area, then I can go for max width property. For example, I'm taking it as 500 pixel. Now observe guys, it is going to take only a maximum width of 500 pixel instead of the entire document. For example, I'm going to take the 100 pixel. Right, it is getting. Now it is something like vertical element of the buttons. Okay, now fine. So I hope I have shown clearly for both the inline and block level elements. Yeah, and now we'll take another type of value. Inline block. So this inline block acts as an inline element. And it allows you to set height and width of the element. Yeah. So whereas coming to inline, for every inline element, if you take any kind of inline element, you can't set height and width of the element. Whereas coming to inline block, if you wish to set the height and width of the element, then we can go for inline block. Okay, fine. For example, let me take the list tag, right? So if you observe here, the list tags I have defined as display inline, right? Home, sign up, nothing, ongoing. Right? These are all the inline elements. If I wish to set the height, for example, I have set the height as 100 pixel. Is it modified? Is any modification? No. Doesn't modify anything. Yeah. Whereas coming to normal display property for example, I will write here. Not works as inline. If you go for anchor tags converting to block level element, here if you write height equal 100 pixel. Now observe, guys, what happened? Yes, it is modified. Meaning that by default, block elements having a property we can set like height and width, Whereas inline elements, we can't set height and width. If we wish to have an element as inline element, and for that element also, if you would like to set height and width, then I will go for specifically inline block. Inline block, yeah. So I don't want this thing. Works as block level. Now, what I will do is observe, guys. If I refresh, what happened? If I convert this into block level element, I can able to set the height. Yes. The thing is, these are all arranged in the form of line by line. I don't want like that. I want to arrange them in a kind of the previous one as it is, and I would like to set the height and width. For that, can I go with display equal inline? No. If you wish to apply height as 100 pixel, it doesn't apply. So for that, what we can do is we can go for display equal to inline block, and observe. Is there any modification? No. It looked like the same as previous one. Now, if you wish to change the height, you can go for changing its height. Am I right or not? Yes. That is the difference between inline and inline block. For example, I would like to make it for only 30 pixels. Meaning that my own adjustment of buttons. Now, next kind of property, null. So, to not display an element, we'll go for display value as null. Guys, observe. For example, I don't want to display this entire unordered list area. Then what I can do, I can go for accessing that data. So I think I have written somewhere, right? Unordered list. Yeah. What I will do is here, I will go for accessing this one. I can go for display equal to none. Meaning that this item doesn't display at all. Completely, it is not visible. Instead, I will go with meaning that wherever you write, those properties will be applicable. Instead, I have written in the form of a list. The unordered list area is displaying, but list of items are not displaying. For example, I would like to remove these images. Then I'll go for display colon and I will I'll make the yeah, meaning that for only one element I have added that class amount. For only one image I have added that class, that is why only one image is not this. So that is the use of display equal to none. Display equal to none. Yeah, sometimes we can use it in a different way. Some guys try to observe. What I will do is so I will go with the one second. Let me have some way. Yeah. So before branches, I will take or I will take the branches concept here. Yeah. What I will do is I will take one division area. I will take the class as display hyphen yeah, some meaning, it's having some meaning, that's it, nothing other than that, nothing. I'm taking it as RGUKT Srikakulam. RGUKT Srikakulam. Yeah, now what I did is I'm going to add one image same as like this n dot jpg n.jpg. yeah, I am going to set height and width. Height is 250 pixel, width is 300 pixel, 300 pixel. Yeah, that's it. For example, let me have only to show this property. I am going to add this class as display hyphen visible property. Display hyphen visible property. Yeah. So this image is related to NoseWidth, right? RGKT NoseWidth. Yeah. Guys, what I will do is observe. I will refresh. Yeah. It has taken like this. RGKT NoseWidth. Adjugate news video, and my image got display. What I will do is with the help of this class I will hide this image. Observe. What I will do, I will make display as none. Sir, yeah, so what happening here? So instead of somewhere, I will add somewhere. So for timing, yeah, I will add after branches. I have added, so that display area is none, right? That is why that image is not displaying. Now what my requirement is, whenever I place cursor here, meaning that I would like to apply hovering effect, at that time I need to display this data. Yes, fine. How we are going to find the hovering effect? So whenever I place hovering on this RGKT NoseWidth, for that what you can do, dot d hyphen n colon hover. Yeah, fine. What I need to do, I need to make display of the child elements. What I can do, I can make display equal to some inline, meaning that this display property for none will be converted to display property as inline. Now observe, guys. I hope it will works. Yeah, fine. So whenever I place cursor on RGKT NoseWidth, the image is displaying or not. Yes, that is the advantage of display none. So generally it generally specifically used at JavaScript. Whenever you want to hide the data, whenever you want to view the data, then you go for display equal none property. Yes, observe. So as it is a block level element, wherever I can place, I can get this data. Yeah, I want to get this as block level, meaning that I would like to get in the form of next line. Observe, it's getting the next line. Yeah, like this we can use your thing. See, observe. Whenever I place cursor, I will get the data. Yes, that is the advantage of display equal to none. Yeah, guys, here one more important point. There are one more property, which is visibility property. Visibility property is there. visibility property is there, right? So this visibility property is meant for to define whether an element is visible or not, meaning that we can able to define whether an element should be visible or not. That thing we can define with the help of visibility property. Here it will support two values. One is hidden, another one is visible. If you write like the value as visible, the corresponding value will be displayed on the screen. If you write visibility equal to hidden, it is going to hide from the screen, meaning that which is similar to display equal to none. But there is a difference, guys. Observe, what I will do is you can observe the difference. Instead of taking display equal to none, I will take the visibility property. Visibility equal to hidden. If you make observe, guys, in the previous I have used display equal to none. That is why it is displaying like this. Yeah, fine. If I refresh, what happened, guys? Arjuket Nuzvid is there or not? Yeah, Arjuket Nuzvid is there. And also, so whenever I have used the visibility property hidden, I have to, if I would like to go for display that, I have to use visibility equal to visible. Observe. What happened, guys? Arjuket Nuzvid is there. Whenever I place cursor, it is displaying. Yes, am I right or not? Yes. But what you observed from the previous, observe. One second, I'm making uncomment. Yeah. Observe, guys. In the previous, I have it has occupied some space or not. Now, if I refresh, it doesn't occupy any space. Whenever I place cursor, I'm getting my data. Meaning that the difference between this visibility equal to hidden and display equal to none means display equal to none doesn't occupy any space, whereas visibility equal to hidden occupy space. Okay, no, fine. So this is the difference between this visibility equal to hidden and display equal to none. So this is the concept of display property. So I hope it is clear for everyone. Okay, fine. So I will continue the position property in the next class. Thank you.